sought vain glory. He never, esteemed himself more than others. Amen. He always took the position that I'm nothing without God, and I can do all things through him. Amen. That's the attitude that we must have. Paul always said, I'm the least of all of my brethren. He said, I am what I am because of what the grace of God. He says that I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless, I live, but it's not me. It's the Christ that what lives on the inside of me. Paul didn't take any credit for all that God had done through him, and yet he was a great man. In fact, Paul's exaltation or rewards and accomplishment included, he was the only one that had the revelation of the justification by faith. Justification by faith is a big doctrine that God showed him. That was a great revelation. The revelation of righteousness, who we are in Christ, came through Paul. The mystery of the rapture, none of the Old Testament's prophets, they never talked about the rapture. It was over 6,000 prophecies. I think, I'm not sure, but the 6,000 or 3,000 pointed to Christ is coming to the earth to rule and reign. But no Old Testament prophet had a revelation that Jesus was going to come for the church or to rapture the church. Not a single one. The type of the rapture appeared in the Old Testament under the Feast of the Harvest, the first fruits. That was a type of the rapture. The rapture was included in that particular time. But in terms of Old Testament prophets having a revelation of Jesus coming for the church, no one had it. No one had it in the New Testament, but Paul had the revelation that Jesus was coming. Amen. And he was going to come and what? Take the church before he comes to the earth to rule and to reign. All right, so if Paul hadn't been submitted to God and so humble, and he's the one that taught a whole lot of these things that we hear about, not thinking more highly than you ought to think about yourself. That's found in Romans 12. That's what he taught. In Galatians 5, he taught not to be desirous of vain glory. So he talked about, he says, wherefore let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he falls. So Paul really stressed the importance of staying little or staying humble and not believing lies about yourself. You know, the devil wants to make you believe that what you're the most important person around. Amen. How many know that sometimes there's a temptation to get puffed up when the Lord blesses you? It's hard to stay humble. They say when you get rich or when you get famous. Okay, well, of course none of y'all know about that, don't you? You don't know about that, but some of y'all are probably going that direction, so you need to learn how to what? Stay humble, even with the limited resources that God has blessed you with. Amen. Amen. What I mean by that, give all glory to God. Don't ever feel that you're sufficient of yourself to think anything of yourself. Let me ask you a question. What do you have that you didn't receive? Amen. What do you have that you didn't receive? Scripture says every good and every perfect gift. I'm not going to shout too loud today. I'm not going to get too excited because it's hot. I'm already hot. Thinking about pulling this coat off. So I'm going to just take it easy and just talk to you. Amen. Every good and every perfect gift cometh from above. So if you can remember that, amen. And whenever you are tempted to get puffed up, you can say, what do I have that God didn't give me? You know, most times people want to be in the lamb like they want to. You know, people get caught up in titles and positions, and you know, they get caught up in recognition, and everybody want to be superstar, top dog. Okay, everybody want to be the chief. Nobody want to be an Indian. Everybody want to be what? The star. Amen. And you know, when you prosper, when you're gifted, when you're talented, when your gift makes room for you, when your money begins to expand and to supply, and multiply, and you know, we are warned to be very cautious when you really begin to prosper. And your money is multiplied, your silver and gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied. The Bible says, remember, amen, remember to praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Remember. So, you know, I attend meetings sometimes and I see how proud the bishops are, the apostles, the prophetesses, and the prophets. You know, they really feel good about their places and their positions many times, to the extent that they kind of look down, you know, on people that are inferior to them. And, you know, the desire for power and glory is real strong. Is that right? Amen. Someone said that the three G's is the one that really causes much problems for many, many, many men of God. The three G's. That's glory. Everybody said glory.
Glory.
Amen. Gold.
Money.
Right. The next one is what?
Girls.
Girls. Hallelujah. And the thing is that when you get so big in stature, when you prosper, I heard one of your favorite men of God that get y'all happy all the time. There were some things that were said that many times that is a real challenge to not get full of pride and really begin to display qualities that are not in harmony with the Word of God. This is the thing that made me like Jim Baker. Is that right? Name some more. Amen. Some of the top men. Amen. On TV, radio, Jimmy Swagger. And you hear them all. Some of them got caught up in, you know, homosexuality. Some got caught up in prostitution. You know, some, their big cars were seen in red light districts. And all of these things happen when sometimes people feel like they're so powerful, they don't have to what, obey God. They can avoid the consequences of what? Disobedience. You don't believe people think that way. Once you get so exalted, you know, all the money you need, you have all of the glory and honor, positions, recognition, on hundreds and thousands of TV stations. Amen. That is something that a lot of times people cannot deal that well with unless they really begin to exert a lot of self-restraint. You know, you have to really exert a lot of self-restraint and be persistent in prayer. And you really have to see, humility is something that you don't really understand completely. See, pride is so natural, it's real insidious and hidden from our sight, nothing so difficult and dangerous. Nobody that get lifted up in prayer think that they are lifted up. They don't think that. They just say, well, I'm just obeying God. I'm just, carrying out my call. But many times people don't ever think that they are operating in prayer. I'm sure if they had really recognized that they were operating in prayer, they wouldn't have just deliberately let themselves get caught in those snares that really brought them down. It's no fun going from $150 or $200 million a year intake to barely scraping, maybe just getting $1 million or two a year, or less than that. That's no fun. Now, who would deliberately pull something that will cause them to fall from that high state to that low state? Nobody in their right mind. So that shows that it's something hidden and subtle that people don't even have a clue. Let me just give you an illustration. I'm just talking today from the scripture. If you would turn to, this is a real good scripture here, is Mark 12, 38 through 40. It says, this is how our people can flaunt their ability and their importance. They can flaunt it. And scripture says that will bring them down every time. That will bring them down every time. See, pride brings shame. That's Proverbs 11, 2. Pride brings contention. And pride brings one low. And so this scripture says, beware of the scribes which love to go in long clothing and love salutation in the marketplace. See, everybody like to be called, amen, prophetess and bishop and, pastor, evangelist, people, missionary, people sometimes gloat in positions. And the scripture says the scribes loved to go in long clothing. They loved the salutations in the marketplaces and the chief seats in the synagogues and the uppermost rooms at the feast. But the Bible says that at the same time, they were flaunting their ability and their importance. They were devouring widows' houses. And for a pretense, made long prayers. Amen. So they were acting spiritually. They were acting like they were Super Sally, a Holy Joe, a sky pilot. But at the same time, they were stealing from the widows' houses. They were cheating widows out of their possessions. And they were covering up by offering long prayer. It looked real and deep. But sometimes people act real deep. Every once in a while, they will quicken. That makes you look real, real deep. And sometimes people just like to be looked upon as being what? Real, real spiritual. Amen. But you don't want to have no part of it because what? If man put you up, they can take you down. But if God put you up, nobody can take you down. Amen. Okay, now here is a passage here you want to know. Mark 10, 35, 45. See, Jesus talks consistently throughout the scripture. He taught things like he says that, I don't seek my own glory. He says, I don't receive honor from no man. I don't get caught up in what? Receiving honor of men. That's what Jesus said in John 5:41. I don't receive honor from men. I don't seek my own glory. My doctrine ain't mine. My works I perform, they are not mine. I only do, for I always do those things that please him. I always do those things that please him. See, that was Jesus' attitude even when he relinquished his place in glory, his power in glory. He just laid it aside. And all of those outward powers that he could have held on to as God, because he was equal with God, but he made of himself no reputation, and he relinquished all of those divine attributes that made him God. And he came down in the form of a servant. You say, you won't have a better example than Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. It's kind of like Saddam, what's that name? Saddam Hussein, that went from billionaire, and the day they finally tracked him down, he was in a what? He was in a cave. He went from all of those, what you call them? He had a whole lot of places, headquarters, they were fabulous palaces. He had these palaces spread all over the place. But the day that he went down, see, pride brings shame. He came down. Came down. And when they got him out, he didn't have no suit on. He didn't have no tie. He didn't have all that fancy stuff around him. He was just trying to survive in that little hole. He was trying to keep from getting caught. Amen. Somebody said God's way up is down. God's way of adding is subtracting. Seek to save your life, you'll lose it. But if you lose it for Christ's sake, you'll what? You'll find it. Some pastor been beat around, tossed around. Amen. Praise God. I tell you everything that I've gone through since I've been pastor here, you would cry. You would cry. I can't tell you how many times that I've denied myself of things that were rightly mine, just to keep this place open. But God's word said that if we humble ourselves, that he was going to what? Exalt us in what? Due time. I believe I'm ripe for a blessing. Amen. I believe I'm good and ripe for a what? Big blessing. Amen. God has blessed me, but I believe the greater blessings are still what? Still ahead. How many can say amen? Okay, now here is something that should destroy or burn out all selfish ambition out of your life, because this is just a natural response that we have as people, God's people as well. Okay? Okay, here is Mark 10, 35 through 45. It says, and James and John, the sons of Zebedee, come unto him, saying, Master, we would that thou shouldest do for us whatsoever we shall desire. And he said unto them, what would ye that I should do for you? They said unto him, grant unto us that we may sit one on thy right hand and the other on thy left hand in thy glory. See, this was what they desired. One wanted to be right next to Jesus in his glory. Amen. They want to be the top disciples. And he said unto them, what should ye that I should do for you? They said unto him, grant unto us that we may sit one on the right hand, the other on the left hand, in thy glory. But Jesus said unto them, ye know not what ye ask. Can ye drink of the cup that I drink of, and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with? And they said unto him, we can. And Jesus said unto them, ye shall indeed drink of the cup that I drink of, and with the baptism that I am baptized withal shall ye be baptized. But to sit on my right hand and on my left hand is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. In other words, the glory that they were seeking is the only way that can be restored. It has to be earned. It has to be, you have to deserve it. It has to be, amen, something that merit, amen, the glory for responding to the will of God. Amen. Hallelujah. How many can say amen?
Amen.
So that's the way you're going to be exalted. You have to what? Submit to God. You have to do His will. Amen. And God said He will what? Exalt you in due time. See, Paul was exalted in due time. As I said earlier, the mystery of the rapture, he was the only one that received that. He was primarily, through his ministry, primarily the destiny of Christianity was established. Can you imagine? Paul was the one that was responsible for the destiny of Christianity all over the world. It was through his ministry, his labors, his letters, his suffering, his commitment, and the pain and the heartache and all that he had gone through enabled him to establish Christianity at that time in the entire world, the known world. And then he liberated the world from the yoke of legalism. Paul did that. Now his writings, his revelation of Jesus Christ, you won't believe this, make up a half of the New Testament writings. But he was, I'm the least of all of my brethren. He said, I am what I am.
Yeah.
And I like this in Philippians 3:3. He said, we, the circumcisions, we worship the Lord in spirit. Ooh, glory. He said, amen. We worship the Lord in what? Spirit. We rejoice. See, that's how you demonstrate your humility. You worship the Lord in spirit. So when you don't do it in spirit, just do it the way you want to. Hold back. Look wise and otherwise. Amen. Praise God. Won't release yourself. Won't submit and worship. Amen. That's not worshiping the Lord in spirit. He said, we worship Him in spirit, we rejoice. Oh, we rejoice in Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hashata. Glory. And then he said, and we have no confidence in the flesh. He said, I ain't gonna get one just like you. I don't receive one from you. I ain't gonna receive no glory. Nobody gonna pin no flowers on me. Nobody gonna make me believe lies about myself. How important, how fabulous, how astute, how wise, and how... How many know knowledge can puff you up? Amen. The more you learn, the more you ought to learn, know where you ought to perceive how ignorant you are. Amen. Amen. Every good and every perfect gift cometh from what? The Bible says, don't let the wise man glory in his what? Wisdom. Don't let the wise, amen, the mighty man glory in his what? Might. Don't let the rich man glory in his riches. But him that glory, let him glory that may know me, and may know me, amen, and in me is hidden all of the riches, all of the wealth, and all of the things that man desire is in me. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and say, Lord, I want you. Hey, see, ha, 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 ha. Come on, let me hear you. Come on, just lift your hands and say, Lord, I want you. Lord, I need you. Lord, I feel a need for you. Lord, Lord, without you. Oh, this was the attitude that Jesus had. He said, Lord, without you, I could do nothing. Hallelujah. Every good and every perfect. prayer figure. This is what Paul said. Coming from above, from the Father, Father of lights. Amen. I believe James said that in him, in whom there is no variableness, neither of no shadow of turning. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, just lift your hand. Just give God praise, because we've been talking about stay humble. If you stay humble, God will what? He will release. He will release, amen, grace, God doing for you what you can't do for yourself. God's unmerited favor, the sum total of all that God has done through Christ and now is doing through the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God wants to release. The Bible says he's able to cause all grace to abound toward you so you will have sufficiency in everything. Amen. But when you lift it up in prayer, that means that God what? Resists the proud. In other words, you're not in the range where God's grace can be released into your life when you operate in prayer. God resists the proud. How many of us came to your wife? She wasn't too pleased with you. Put her arms around you. She just took it off.
Y'all didn't have enough experience like that, have you?
She just checked your arm away. You thought you were trying to make love. You had a man by some. You hadn't cleared it up. You hadn't humbled yourself. You hadn't submitted. Amen. And she just said, I don't want none of that. All right. Come on. God resists the proud, but he gives grace, what? To the humble. Well, I don't know about y'all. I'm going to stay little. One day, God is going to, amen, supply all the missing pieces. Amen. Whatever it takes, money, or whatever it takes to make this ministry what it ought to be. Hallelujah. If I stay faithful, if I stay on track, how many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. If I don't get puffed up, glory, hallelujah, and try and rely on my ability. But as Jesus said, hallelujah, I can do nothing without what? Without God, I can do nothing. So there has to be a feeling of what need.
Yes.
A sense of need. Everybody just say, a sense of need. A sense of need. If you feel like you already got it together, amen, you can forget it. God resists you. But if you feel like you ain't got nothing, praise God, of yourself. You know, I believe that humility is not just saying, amen, that I, you know, thinking bad and low. But you are not to think more highly of yourself than you ought to think. We know who we are in Christ. We can boast in who we are in Christ. But you are not what you are in Christ in yourself. Paul says, no more I, but it's the what? Christ that lives in me. The life I used to live in the flesh, I now live by the what? Faith of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
I am what I am because of the grace of God.
Amen.
It wouldn't be good if everybody just developed an attitude. See, it wouldn't be no problem getting exalted. God is going to exalt you in what? Due time. Hallelujah. God is going to release. The Bible says he resists the proud, but he gives what? Grace. He's going to what? Release his loving care into your life. He's going to fill your life with grace. No good thing. Ooh, I love it. No good thing. God will what? Give grace and glory.
Yes, he will.
No good thing will he withhold from them that will walk upright before him.
Yes.
So God is going to be released into your life when you submit to God. And then the scripture says, amen, if we submit to God, we can resist the devil.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You know, I believe that any woman or man would love to have a spouse that had the ability to what? Resist the devil.
All right.
If they knew that he was willing and able to resist the devil, praise God, they would have no doubts and no reservations, glory, concerning that spouse. If he had the willingness, y'all hear what I'm saying? If he had the willingness, you know, sometimes people are willing, but they ain't got the ability. You gotta have the willingness and the ability.
Yes, amen.
But God gives you the what? Grace. Oh, hallelujah. And you can resist the devil. You can ask anything in Jesus' name. Oh, I love that.
Yes.
And the Bible says, God will run. He'll do it.
Yes, he
Jesus said,
yes.
If you demand anything,
yes,
in my name, I'll do it.
Yes.
And in the book of Job, it says, whatever ye decree, it shall be what? Established.
Yes.
And the light shall shine on that pathway. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, lift your hands. Stay on your feet. Oh, God. Stay humble. And the way you stay humble is your attitude you have in prayer. If you don't, amen, feel the need for it, then you lift it up in prayer. Hallelujah. That's the reason why I want to see people that feel the need enough to be here on Sunday morning at 9 o'clock. Well, that is the epitome of prayer. When you can do all of this stuff for God that we are scheduled to do during this 2-hour period before God has a chance to do something for you in prayer. Amen. So this is how we miss it, because we don't know what submission is. Submission is not just being submitted to God and to His, you know, God and Jesus. That's all I obey. I ain't gonna obey no pastor. Ain't no man gonna tell me what to do. See, God resists the proud, because the criteria for getting God's grace released into your life, you have to be subject to one another. The younger has to be subject to the older. That means your elders and people that God places over you. If your elder tells you that you need to be here at 9, if you're participating in things and you are not subject to that, and then you're trying to what? Resist the devil can say, Just like those 7 sons of Sceva. And they were trying to call devils out of them. They said, who are you trying to call a devil out of me? Jesus I know, Paul I know, but I don't know nothing about you.
All right.
And they didn't come out, but they jumped out. And what? They tore them asunder. They gave them a run for their money. They were trying to operate without submitting. That's a bad thing. Take somebody and say, that's a bad thing. Y'all hear the pastor. Well, I've been telling some of y'all for you months and years, you need to be here at 9 o'clock to pray if you're going to do something for God. Let God do something for you.
Yeah.
People trying to have church and do all this stuff for God, ain't prayed in the Spirit, ain't united their spirits in nothing. And here they are trying to what? Put on a show. Amen. I'm going to dance in a few minutes. Some of y'all get mad. If you get mad, that's too bad. Because the Bible, and I'm standing on the Bible. You can't prove how you're doing lands up with the Word, but I can prove what I'm saying, how it lands up with the Word.
All right.
And this is the reason why God resists people that do not submit.
Yeah. All right.
Amen. I'm going to shut down. Bow your head if you can. I'm going to shut it down. Father, today we thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
That we have a whole lot to learn about submission. Oh, God. One thing that we do know, that God's love and kindness can't be released into our lives unless we are in submission.
Yeah.
God's love, God's loving care can't be received. God's grace can't be released. God's power can't be released to us. Lord, we must understand that we place ourselves out of the boundary where God's grace can be released into our lives when we do not adhere and submit to the man of God and those that God placed over us. For you said, be subject one to another. That's what you said in 1 Peter 5:5. Be subject. For God resisted the proud, but he gives what? Grace to the humble. Amen. You said that if we humble ourselves, that we will be exalted. In other words, God will open doors. God will establish us. God will promote us. He will open doors. He will cause things that we are believing for to be released into our lives. We will be exalted in due time. And Father, you said if we submit to God, we would have the ability to resist the devil. We can talk to the mountain. Tell the mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea. We don't doubt in our heart, but believe that those things that we say shall come to pass, it shall happen. Amen. It shall happen according to as what we have said. Oh God, we thank you, hallelujah, for your promises. We have three distinct promises regarding staying humble or in submitting to you, that you will do these things. Father, we give you praise and we give you the glory in Jesus' name. Prayers won't work. Amen. I don't care who prays. Hallelujah. If the grace of God can't be released into our lives, all of the prayers are going to be of no avail. But Lord, today, I open my heart. I will declare my need. Lord, I need you. Come on, lift your hands up. Lord, I need you. I need help. I'm going to say it. I need help. Lord, without you, I can do nothing. Lord, I don't have it. I mean, it's not of my own strength, of my own doing. My sufficiency is not of me, Lord, but my sufficiency is of you. Lord, help me to be mindful of how I am operating in the kingdom. The mistakes I have made, the misunderstanding that I'm operating from, help me to understand that you resist the proud. Those that don't regard those that they are under. Just intent on doing things the way that they want to do them. Things that's convenient for them. Father, I pray today.